at today, Jesse? We're here for you.
Today we're at Black Bear Off-Road with our homie Bubba.
You got some other homies Bubba here. You've seen enough of Bubba.
Chuno Chaboy. So we're here to outfit my Jeep. Shout out to Rugged Ridge. We've got this pallet.
This has been in my way for like a week. In all these fields. Shout out to Rugged Ridge.
Shout out to Mamba Off-Road.
Mamba Off-Road. Oh, yeah. Mamba Off-Road.
I haven't seen these. I
haven't smelled
them.
They're extreme. Oh. You got a feel up on them too. They got a nice
These are the ones that I wanted to put on the Sonoma.
Ooh, they feel so smooth. Like, I want to rub my... We'll come back to this.
Okay, so for those of you who might not know, Jesse is, you know, one of the partners of the magazine. He does a lot of video, writing stuff, photography with us. He has had the same Toyota Corolla his entire life. And at 30 years old, he decided to splurge a little bit. And he got himself his dream off-road toy. He got, what, a 2016?
2016
JKU
Wrangler
stock.
Unlimited.
So like he said, Rugged Ridge was kind enough to work with us for 2020. And we are basically, what do you say, Bubba, like 20K worth of parts today? Easy.
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 At 20. Least 10K in labor.
Check out my boy just rolled up.
Look at you. You just look like you came from a party.
Look at all these Mambas, man.
What?
Mambas for days.
And donuts.
And donuts, bro.
Oh, snap.
Oh, snap.
Oh. I didn't know we put them in the mag.
Nationally published.
All right, yeah, so the goal for today is to basically get this 20K worth of parts, suspension wheels, and tires on in one day. Unfortunately, the tires didn't get here in time, so we'll have to cut to when the tires get here to be able to mount and balance them on the wheels. But as soon as the Toyo tires get here, what's he got coming? He's got Toyo Open Country MTs,
35, 12, 50, 18, 17.
So yeah, we're definitely gonna be using some of that CRC.
Well, so will.
I mean, like, the thing is, of course he wants 37s, right? But he doesn't have a Rubicon, and the reality of going to 37s is gonna mean you gotta re-gear, really gotta build up the axles. This is his daily Jeep. It's his street car. Put this thing on the highway. So 35s are, you know, they're the right choice for somebody who's gonna do something like that with a Jeep.
And that's not to say it's not capable off-road, because the first time...
Oh, it's going to be super capable. Yeah. Like, my Jeep was at a real sweet spot when it was on 35. It flexed well. It drove pretty good. It was happy. Then I go to 37s, and then you just start breaking all the thing, like sequentially just breaking the next weak link. So 35s is going to be... I know, you know, you think magazine, you think, oh, they're going to put it on 40s, but... I mean, for everyday usability, 35 MT Toyo, it's going to have a good shoulder on it. It's going to be good.
It's going to be good.
I think it's time for a little unboxing montage. What do you think?
It sure is. Cue the music. We got 2.5 inch lift kit from Superlift with Fox struts. We have front bumper, rear bumper, tire carrier, rock sliders. You got fenders, wheels, tires, and a grill. There it is.
Ooh, I needed that.
Okay, so adding a front bumper, we're gonna add protection. But we're also gonna add clearance. We're gonna add some room for approach angle from the tires by not having that factory bumper. It's gonna improve the approach angle as we're going up rocks, coming down rocks, but it's also gonna give us the ability to mount a winch. That's gonna be great for self-recovery. Also, the factory recovery points, not very good. So the new bumper that's going on, it's gonna have some great recovery points. So we're gonna add some fenders to this thing. That's gonna give us some higher clearance and protection against trees. You run this plastic into a tree, it's just gonna rip off, it's gonna dent your fender, basically. We're doing headlights. Factory headlights are made out of candles on a Jeep. They're terrible. They're like 4 lumens, so we're gonna replace those. These floppy rubber just awful hood latches. They're getting replaced with a metal one by Rugged Ridge. That's gonna help with hood flutter. Hood flutter happens a lot on these Jeeps. Bully's ripping off these grandpa style side steps. These are old school, these are from the 1980s and they worked then, but we have something way better now. It's gonna protect us against rocks. So we're gonna throw those on. We're doing suspension. Got a lift kit going on so we can fit bigger tires and to add some clearance. And in the back, we're at this XD tire carrier. Basically, it's heavy duty. If you leave a 35-inch tire on a factory tire carrier, you'll just rip this whole door off going down the trail. So we beefed it up with these hinges. I mean, it's 3-4 times thicker than the factory hinge. Then a rear bumper, added protection coming off of rocks. It's gonna have the same recovery points. Basically just give you all around better protection, approach, and departure angle. Basically, you want to do all these things so when you take this thing off-road, you're gonna have a well-performing vehicle. It's kind of like building a tuner for the track or for road course. There's specific parts you need to perform at optimal level in your environment.
Look at Wooly getting his hands dirty.
That's going over there.
I'm just gonna rip this crap off. I don't feel like it's necessary after today.
What crap are you talking about?
All these little plastic craps back here, little plastic clips for this plastic pointless thing.
Is this new bumper gonna maintain fog lights?
I believe so.
Yeah.
Actually, didn't he get some like Amazon's finest fogs? I think he did.
He got headlights.
And fogs, I think.
Oh, did you get fog lights too?
So did.
Oh, look at you go, thinking ahead.
That's kind of ricey, but they've got some RGB halos.
I love all the signs, Bubba.
Thank you. I wanted to feel like Cracker Barrel in here.
And now a word from our sponsors.
What you got going on here and how can people find it?
BlackBearOffroad.com. It's easy to spell. It's BlackBearOff-Road, like it looks in Webster's Dictionary. We do everything. We work on every kind of vehicle. We have C7 Corvettes in here, Jeeps, trucks, whatever. But our specialty, bread and butter, is off-roading and overlanding. If you got a Tacoma, if you got a Jeep Wrangler, whatever, we can lift you up, put you some new wheels and tires on there, get everything outfitted to do whatever you want to do off-road.
Right here in downtown
Buford. Right here in downtown Buford, Georgia.
Yep.
Born and raised, huh?
Hell yeah. Dude, that thing's got some weight to
Listen,
it.
That's a big bar.
We got spices.
It's a big bar.
Braking knowledge is gone, man. Except for Hollywood.
Fine, dude, you've had these headlights forever.
This is the first purchase I made because, all right, the headlights that come stock on here are just horrible. I mean, you're better off holding a flashlight outside of the driver's side. So the first purchase I made were these. I have no idea. I saw some reviews. They look fine. The price wasn't too cheap, but it wasn't like too high. It was like a middle point. And yeah, they look good. They're LEDs. So honestly, whatever you get outside of the stock headlights, you're going to be upgrading. Yeah.
Long live the rice.
Are you drinking a beer? It's 9:30 in the morning.
Orange juice. Guys, come on. Come on.
Tropicalia.
What you can do at home is just to drill some holes.
You can drill these out.
And
yeah.
Then you're going to pop out those sections there, or you can just get big and just take a fender off.
That's the therapy I need.
So now you know, if a Jeep bomber takes your parking spot, you just go, yeah, okay. Another little Jeep troll is that from the factory on these doors, there's a little nut that comes on the bottom of there. Everybody takes them off and they take the doors off and never puts them back on. So if you see like a bunch of Jeeps parked outside the Taco Mac, you can go change all their doors.
Just mismatch everybody.
The orange ones on the white Jeep, the white ones on the orange Jeep.
Have fun.
Yeah.
See you. I'll have a blast documenting your frustration. Actually, actually, let's call it here. Let's have a little montage of Wooly's frustration of putting these fenders on.
I'm gonna go through the range of emotions on this one.
Cue it.
12 seconds later.
I'm not doing it.
There it is. I told you guys.
Get Bubba to put the factory ones back on. Oh, wait.
How you feeling?
Does it?
How you feeling, Wooly?
I don't think you really need fenders.
I think you need fenders.
No, they make little flush mount kits that you can just put on these things.
No way!
Hey,
it might want us to take these fenders back off. I ain't feeling that.
How was the frustration? Did you get over your frustration?
You're acting like we're done. We're on step 3 out of a hardback book of instructions over there.
Aww, this.
He's getting in there, he's trying to chop it up nice and good there. He's got his little dremel, he's cutting it right.
Let the jury be made aware and the record show that I did not have a full come apart. I have mild frustration.
That's your big.
Which is all part of enjoying the victory.
How you feeling, Bubba?
I love Jeeps. Love everything about them.
And as we see over here, it's mating season. So typically the Dachs would mount on the smaller one over here. And let's give them some space.
Now a word from our sponsors.
Alright, so yo, check it out. On these kind of janky, not functional rock slider things, they got these rusty, crusty little Allen bolts. Probably going to be a problem. This stuff has saved me a ton. It's the CRC freeze-off. It's been a godsend on my old F-150 that I was working on. But basically, spray these on the threads, walk away for a minute, and come back, and it should come out. If it's going to have a chance of coming out, it'll come out. Came right up. Not a problem. Nice.
Yep. Corona.
Got it. I pretend in my head that I'm Chip Foose.
Those windfall things are fish right there.
Got the winch on there now.
They're coming out.
How you guys doing? It's been a lot of focus on all these suits out here, but how are you? Love of mine, you know? I hope you're staying in school. Staying off those drugs.
Shit, why'd I'm you invite the Busta, man?
Cause the Busta give you an egg.
Hold on. bolts and holes.
It's actually pretty easy to install.
Compared to mine where I had to cut the frame.
No, Rugged Rick did a good job on this one.
Come on. Thank you.
Can you?
Well, that.
Now you have beer as well.
So the test three magazines off the table. How y'all doing? Damn, I'm good looking.
Can we just take a minute? How fine this man is.
This is a razor, pretty much. And one of their buddies was down
to talk to three. Just
three
for everybody.
Three had corn liquor.
How's it feel?
All in. Daggum thing, slicker than a greased elephant.
All right, we are now going on the first cruise.
I'm gonna do a lap.
All your new parts.
Show lamb.
All right, we have everything except the wheels and tires.
Except wheels and tires. Tires are coming in next week. No, we have the wheels.
We have the wheels.
Tires. We got some nice wheels.
They have the wheels.
Yeah, shout out to the Jambulance. So from my experience, there's a lot of cosmetic changes that more have benefit of protection off-road.
Right.
I'm excited to take this on Durhamtown. For my birthday weekend.
For your birthday?
For my birthday weekend. This is a blessing, dude. This is a lot of shit. Yo, and shout out to Bubba and the boys from Black Bear.
Alright, so now that we're back, we're not gonna hold the wheels and tires off to another video. So what we're gonna do now is go ahead and cut over to Jesse holding the camera whenever the wheels and tires come in, because I don't know if I'm gonna be there or not. So let's go ahead and cut over to that.
The following Thursday.
What up?
Back at Black Bear Off-Road. I've got a set of 5 Toyo Open Country MTs, 35 by 12.5. Let's show you what we're wrapping them on. All right. We got Mamba M26s here.
And what got me was your
pillow.
All right, we got some M26s here. They're pretty dope. I'm a fan. 10 out of 10, would recommend. I believe that.
Yo.
Yo, okay, I'm gonna be real with you.
Yo, be real.
So, when I first saw him online, I wasn't quite sure, especially with the color, but I think the contrast of that like desert tan color with the green, it's pop.
When we were first talking about these wheels, like it was more of a experiment, right? Like Jesse was a little unsure. He wanted, what did you
I
want?
I think it was like.
You wanted bronze. I think it was the M19s or something like that. I don't remember, but it was like, yo, let's try these. The Jeep is tank green. Let's try a tactical wheel and a tactical color. And we were just rolling the dice. But like, I'm jealous, dude.
Yeah,
I'm pumped. And it takes a lot to get me pumped. Jeep guys, truck guys have always wanted the black.
Black on black.
The matte black, rock star.
Since 2007.
Nickelback on, you know, bracelets, whatever. Like, and then it started to go bronze. Bronze has like caught. You know, for a while, it's just the import guys were throwing bronze on Toyotas, and,
I'm
now
seeing polished aluminum now, too.
Polished aluminum is
that's
getting big.
So this color's been around forever, but nobody's put it on a wheel. People have, like, painted their vehicles that color, done wraps, but I haven't seen it on a wheel, really.
You know, the dealerships that put the wheels on the Jeeps when you buy them, they're never going to buy
just
these because it's too polarizing.
Right.
Like, if you want something custom, it's cool. This is bold, dude. Props to Mamba and Koenig for making something that, you know, wasn't
car guy
black. the car guy didn't love it. want honesty in this media company.
Yeah.
No fake news.
No, I'm just saying I was balancing this tire. You can see the ounces. So before I put any weight on it, it just wants 2.5 ounces. I'm just saying Toyos and Nittos like are literally the easiest, best balancing tires. We did some general grabbers 2 days ago and they all want a 9.5, 10 ounces of weight. And that's just the quality of the tire and how it's made.
Later.
Do that. Trick.
Well, Bubba, what time is it?
Game time.
Show
actually,
list.
I think it's like 10:45.
Okay. So what happened?
Basically, we tried to press a stud in by using a bunch of washers, which is a trick that typically works. And what it did is it pulled all the thread off of the nut and the stud. So we had to run to a store, the only auto parts store open till 10 o'clock, get another stud. This time we pulled the entire axle shaft. You can see it puked on the floor. We pulled it out, pressed it in on a bench vise, and now we have a pretty stud. And yeah, Jesse bit pretty much, we took his old wheels off and there was just a boogered up stud. We were gonna change it real quick and it turned in basically a disaster, but whatever, we're fixing it.
What the hell?